editor-in-chief, investigative reporter, justthenews.com. Whatever happened? Now, remember when the Comey to Brennan email was discovered very late, obviously, at the end of the Trump presidency? And he says, yeah, I can't verify any of this. Wasn't that email after he had already sworn to the FISA court that it was verified and prior to him swearing twice more to the FISA court that, in fact, it's verified and true?
Yes, it is. January 12th, 2017 will be a day that if John Durham brings criminal charges, it will be a day that people will remember. Why? Three things happened that day. James Comey signed the first renewal of the FISA warrant saying, I affirm the information in here is verified, including the stuff about Christopher Steele. That same day, he writes James Clapper and says, we've not been able to sufficiently verify anything in the Steele campaign. And then that same day, the CIA comes in and says, hey, guess what, fellas? We have now confirmed some of the information in the Steele dossier is not only wrong, unverifiable, it came from Russian intelligence as a disinformation campaign. That same day, all three things happened. And you have to ask yourself, how could any lawman, go ahead and go to the FISA court when you just learned those two things? You had to knowingly and willfully mislead the court because you knew what you were about to say to the court wasn't true. The CIA was telling you it wasn't true. So I think January 12, 2017 will be a day that lives in infamy if and when the Durham investigation ends with more accountability.
Do your sources have any idea what the hell Durham is even doing?
Yes.
And what's taking so long? And do you believe that the people that we know did all of these things will be held to account?
I don't know. Nobody knows whether he's going to file charges or not. But I will tell you something I affirmed a couple of weeks ago. I've got it from multiple sources. A central senior FBI official who worked in the inner circle of James Comey, between James Comey and Andrew McCabe and Peter Strzok and Lisa Page, began cooperating a few months ago. He's become critical to John Durham's investigation. The delays, some of it was COVID, as we said, but there have been grand jury subpoena fights where witnesses are trying to fight having to turn over evidence, and that's what's delayed John Durham. But right now, they're at the final stages. I'm told that they've made a lot of progress. They've won some of these grand jury subpoena cases, and this cooperating witness, who was very senior in the FBI, don't know his identity, have some guesses, but this senior FBI official has provided really valuable information to understand the mindset and intentions of people like James Comey, Andrew McCabe.
Is one potential person Bill Priestep?
He's certainly one that they ought to be looking at. I don't think he's the cooperating witness. I think it's someone else. FISAs and counterintelligence investigations were not designed to be fishing expeditions. They're supposed to be narrowly targeted, civil liberty protecting. I took all these documents. I went to the former intelligence chief of the FBI, the guy that worked for Robert Mueller when Robert Mueller was the FBI director, and this is what he said. He said, this was unlawful. This investigation was unlawful. It wasn't properly predicated. It's a fishing expedition. And the only explanation I can come up with for why it went on and continued all these years in the absence of evidence is there was political bias, political intention inside the FBI. That's from a G-man. That's how important these documents are.
Okay. And now the courses, I know you have a ton of sources. Why don't you just give us a little bit more detail? Because Halper provided significant exculpatory evidence to the FBI, including the transcripts of conversations he recorded with targeted Trump advisors. And we knew this happened with Papadopoulos. Remember, Papadopoulos had said, no, nobody's talking to the Russians. And if they did, I would consider that treason. But yet they still went after this kid and put him in jail for 2 weeks.
Halper records Carter Page denying in August, before they ever went to the FISA court, he brings Carter Page to his farm in Northern Virginia, and he starts asking Carter Page, did you meet with these two Russians? He keeps asking him time and again. These are the two Russians that Christopher Steele claimed Carter Page was meeting with. And Carter Page says, no, I don't even know these guys. I never met with them. I don't have that level of access. They then go 2 months later, don't tell the court that, and instead said, we have good reason to believe that Carter Page met with these two Russians. They knowingly and willfully lied. In fact, Stefan Halper's information as it relates to Papadopoulos and Carter Page particularly was some of the most damning evidence of innocence that this investigation should never have gone forward, and all of it was kept from the court. Now, next week, we're going to be talking about Stefan Halper again. I'm going to break a big story next week, new declassified documents that show when it came to Stefan Halper and Michael Flynn, The FBI determined early on that some allegations and information that Stefan Halper gave them was inaccurate, erroneous, and yet they continued to use the allegation as a basis to investigate Michael Flynn. When you see what the FBI was writing and telling itself internally, people will be floored that Michael Flynn ever came under investigation, because these documents show they knew the original allegation was false. So we're gonna get to that next week.
Let me go back to a moment when Doug Collins questioned Robert Mueller, and I want to get your reaction to this.
Is it true, the evidence gathered during your investigation, given the questions that you have just answered, is it true the evidence gathered during your investigation did not establish that the president was involved in the underlying crime related to Russian election interference as stated in Volume 1, page 7?
We found insufficient evidence of the president's culpability.
So that would be a yes. That would be a yes.
Yes. That's,
thank you. Isn't it true the evidence did not establish that the president or those close to him were involved in the charged Russian computer hacking or active measure conspiracies, or that the president otherwise had unlawful relationships with any Russian official? Volume 2, page 76. Correct?
I leave the answer to the our report.
So that's a yes. Is that any true your investigation did not establish that members of the Trump campaign conspired or coordinated with Russian government in the election interference activity? Volume 1, page 2, volume 1, page 173.
Thank you. Yes.
Yes. Thank you.
Your reaction to that, and the irony is Hillary paid for a Russian disinformation dossier that became the basis to spy on the Trump campaign and presidency.
If the Mueller investigation had done its work well, it would have been looking at Hillary Clinton for conspiring with Russian sources and a foreign source by the name of Christopher Steele. But they didn't look that direction. It was a one-sided direction. But when I hear that, I'm reminded of one of the most explosive documents that came out last year. FBI agent William Barnett. He was one of Mueller's main guys that worked on Flynn and other things. And he testified to the Justice Department last September. We got these documents very quickly, right after it happened. He said, we never had any evidence of collusion, ever. Not at any point in the investigation did they have evidence of collusion. And then he said, really what the FBI and the Mueller team was doing was playing a bad game of Clue. Put two people in the same room and say, aha, we have collusion. That was the FBI agent mocking his own agency, saying, we did the most awful investigation you ever saw. It was a joke. But when you hear Mueller kind of stumble over his words and try to be careful and lawyerly, the FBI agent who worked right under him, William Barnett, said, listen, I'm going to be straight with you. We never, ever had any evidence of collusion. And yet the American people and Donald Trump went through 3 years of hell.